Hello everyone, and welcome to another installment of Hack.com's weekly cryptocurrency market recap. My name is Sam Borgi, chief editor at Hacked. It is around 11:17 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Friday, which is usually when we like to put these presentations together. I just find that I have a lot more creativity toward the evening. So thank you for joining us wherever you may be. I know we have a very global audience on Hacked. Lots of people tune in from Europe as well as North America. Thanks for joining us. Of course, our goal today, as is the goal every week, is to give you more of a granular look at the cryptocurrency market, analyze the factors that influenced price points. We are happy to report that momentum is returning to the market. It has been doing so for the better part of 2 weeks now. We saw an accelerated momentum around tax day in the US, which was extended by about 24 hours due to some technical issues at the IRS. However, that was only one part of the equation. We are seeing a broader reversal in sentiment more generally, as well as signs of a technical breakout. The Friday session was a complete success if you're a holder of cryptocurrencies. For the first time in a few months, speculative money appears to be returning to the market. We're going to touch upon that and more as we go along today. My email is right on the screen, sam@hack.com. Please message me if you have any questions. You're also free to contact us here on the YouTube page as well as on our main website, hack.com, in the comment section. So our agenda is pretty light. We like to keep it pretty simple on our weekly recap. We want to give you an overall review of what transpired over the previous 7 days. We want to focus more on the global cryptocurrency market and look at major altcoins as well as Bitcoin or really any other market mover that we should be paying attention to. We then want to give you a recap of Hack.com, which, as you know, is one of the fastest growing crypto news sources, crypto resources on the web. We do a lot more than just news and analysis. We provide trade recommendations, and we have a budding community of thousands of members who are active on Workplace. We'd love to have you join us if you're interested. It's hack.com. And we want to also give you more information about what you can expect to see next week as these major themes continue to influence investor sentiment. So at the time of this presentation, the cryptocurrency market had added about 25% this week, comparing it on a 7-day period. The market reached a high of $391 billion on Friday. Technically, if you're evaluating it based on UTC, it was early Saturday. Nevertheless, the market is on an absolute tear. We've gained about $140 billion in market cap since we bottomed about two Wednesdays ago. We bottomed at around $249 billion as a swing low. Since then, you take a look at the rebound that we've seen, it's been nothing short of remarkable. Altcoins have been responsible for the bulk of the gains. Friday, we saw a little bit of a renewed uptrend in Bitcoin, but for most of the gains we saw throughout the week, Ethereum, Ripple XRP, and Bitcoin Cash led the advance. You take a look at these weekly returns, I mean, Ethereum is at 26%, XRP at 44%, and Bitcoin Cash, 50% gains. BCH actually climbed above $1,100 on Friday. XRP was trading above 92 cents. Ethereum was clocking in around $600. So we've seen this before. We've seen this kind of exuberance before. We've seen how quickly the tide can turn. And it seems like sentiment has favored the bulls. A lot of very paramount analysts who have been evaluating crypto for a few years now have forecast that we've seen a bottom in crypto earlier this year and that the market is trending upward. Whether that's the case is yet to be seen. There still are some hurdles, but everything looks very good at the time of writing. Bitcoin, interestingly, stabilized above $8,000. I would say for most of the week it was above that level. We did see a little bit of a drop to around 7,950, 7,900 earlier in the week, but overall it was pretty stable. And as I was putting this presentation together, I took a look over at CoinMarketCap and I saw Bitcoin spike to around 8,900. So again, the momentum is returning. Bitcoin's share of the overall market during peak bull market periods tends to decline. And this is actually a good thing for the cryptocurrency market, right? Because we know that Bitcoin is the cream of the crop. It's the foremost cryptocurrency. It's the first virtual currency. But having the market overly exposed just to Bitcoin isn't really good for long-term health. So the smaller percentage that Bitcoin accounts for crypto in general, the better the market will behave long-term, because it means there's more alternatives out there that can help you diversify into digital assets without having to rely on Bitcoin. So Bitcoin's share of the total market at the time of writing was about 38-39%. We know that it rose back up to around 45-46% amid the bearish downturn over the past few months. Interestingly, Bitcoin's gains persevered despite the so-called Bitcoin whales liquidating hundreds of millions of dollars worth of their coins. So essentially, a Bitcoin whale is somebody who has an oversized position in the currency. Somebody who has that oversized position, has a very large wallet, and decides to make huge moves. This was part of the gain, conceivably, that drove Bitcoin higher a couple weeks ago. It was on Bitfinex, if you recall. We saw one pretty big order that pushed prices above 7,000, and then the rest of the exchanges followed suit. The whales also have a negative impact in that they can offload a huge sum of Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency and influence the market that way. One of the challenges with the cryptocurrency market is there's a very low liquidity when you compare it to other asset classes. That's why you see such huge volatility in Bitcoin and in crypto more generally, is because of that liquidity or lack thereof. So the fact that we unloaded $100 million worth of BTC earlier in the week and Bitcoin was able to shrug it off and drive up another $900 or so says a lot about the current uptrend in the market. We also saw some news around the New York Attorney General's office launching an investigation into regulated exchanges in the state of New York. However, Kraken, which I recently learned is a drink, was actually given to me. So they actually have refused to participate. So the Attorney General's investigation is trying to look at gleaning more transparency into the cryptocurrency market. So they've actually issued questionnaires to Coinbase, Bitfinex, the various major exchanges, and Kraken was also on the list, but it has refused. So we're monitoring that development. We did write about it this week and gave you a broader analysis on the market. We at Hack, we do cover the news. If there's a news item, we do cover it, but we don't simply just cover the news. We provide an analysis of what happened and tie it into the broader market or to a specific part of the market, depending on what that news warrants. Just a little bit of information there. So here's a chart highlighting Bitcoin's performance over the past, 5 days. You see prices peaking around $8,900 on Friday. And this chart here shows you the crypto market uptrend more generally over the past 7 days, courtesy of CoinMarketCap. You see the market peak at around $391 billion based on this chart, gaining tens of billions over the past 7 days. So it looks like we are headed in the right direction. However, lots of things can change. One of the benefits that we've had recently has been a lack of FUD, fear, uncertainty, and doubt. We know that mainstream media, for the most part, has been attacking cryptocurrency. Outright lies reported, outright fake news reported. We've written about that extensively. Don't always believe the news clippings, especially if it's from a source like Express or CNN or anything like that. Surprisingly, I find CNBC does a very good job, more or less, of covering the financial news items. I don't follow them for any other news. But when it comes to reporting on the financial aspect, including cryptos, they tend to do a pretty good job. Wall Street Journal, things like that, tend to have more credibility. And of course, websites like CCN are also covering the market that you should also pay attention to. So overall, a great week if you're a crypto trader. and if you're a hodler as well. So in addition to cryptos, I mean, you know, we make most of our time devoted to the cryptocurrency market, alternative assets. That's not necessarily by design. We essentially, Hacking Finance is designed to help traders, individuals, better get a handle of their financial future. And cryptocurrencies are one way of doing so. They represent a new asset class that can help you diversify your portfolio and overcome the generations of deflation, of inflation, I should say, that have been has been reducing the value of your dollar. So cryptocurrencies are one aspect. They're the biggest aspect, but we also cover stocks, currencies, and commodities as well. Stocks rose at the beginning of the week as earnings began to rise better than expected. However, the gains began to dissipate Thursday and Friday. We saw multiple declines. No real one reason caused it. There were some issues around, you know, rate hike jitters on Friday. Also, some issues around consumer discretionary stocks and consumer staples. Tech stocks also had a tough time on Friday as the S&P and the Dow declined. However, Q1 earnings have been overwhelmingly positive based on the small percentage of S&P 500 companies that have reported. 80% of the S&P so far has reported better than expected earnings per share results, and 72% have posted positive sales surprises. This is according to FactSet. However, I will caution everyone that these expectations, quote-unquote expectations, are a large reason why the stock market rises during earnings. I mean, if I set the bar very low and Company X exceeds it by a wide margin, you know, it's pretty easy to get excited about that, right? There are exceptions, of course. We know that Netflix earlier in the week reported its biggest ever gain in subscribers. That was significant. But overall, you have to be very wary about how the numbers are reported. Also, we talk about earnings growth. Remember, we calculate earnings growth on a year-over-year basis, right? So first quarter of 2017, or I should say fourth quarter of 2017, for example, is compared to the fourth quarter of 2016. Q1 2018 is compared to Q1 2017. So if you know that, you also know that over the past few years, we've just emerged from a so-called earnings recession, right? So earnings were on the rock bottom just a couple years ago. We had just multiple quarters of decline. We've since emerged from that. There is some strength, but sometimes you have to peel back the numbers a little bit to get the actual story. In terms of hack.com, just giving you a recap of some of the articles that we covered this week. We have been pumping out ICO analyses all week long. If you are a member of Hack and you want us to cover an ICO, please participate on the poll on Workplace. And also, guys, please make sure that the project you pick hasn't closed yet, or it's not ongoing, because I've been destroyed in the ratings a few times because I happened to select an ICO that the white list had closed, for example. I mean, there was this one that I covered about a month ago where it seemed like the white list for the pre-sale was closed, but it looked like it was the white list on the whole project. And I got like 1-star reviews on the article, so that I don't like getting 1-star reviews. I like to make sure you guys are happy with the content. So please recommend projects that haven't begun. In terms of the most read articles for the week, these are the top five. You have the Coinbase alert, Amazon is coming, by James Wagner. We had a more chance to go up for Litecoin. We saw the article I wrote there on Stellar prices hitting 6-week highs. Also, some more speculation about the worst being behind us for the crypto market, and the long-term cryptocurrency analysis that also tends to prove popular with our audience. So that's just a recap of some of the content you can expect on Hacked. In terms of what to watch for, some of the common themes I expect to emerge or to continue to influence the market. We're at a crossroads again. You know, is $400 billion the next hurdle? It seems that way at the time that this presentation was given. But as I mentioned earlier, the market can change in a hurry. We are also focusing on the top altcoin plays. I talked about them earlier. Ethereum, XRP, and Bitcoin Cash have really stood out this week, more so than your Stellar and your Litecoin and so on. even though they did perform well. Those three cryptos were the best. Corporate earnings season for Wall Street continues. I don't know why I don't have a period here, but there should be a period. Obviously, we just begun earnings season. A lot more Dow Industrials coming up. A lot of the big players in the S&P are also coming up. Pay attention to that. Trump recently blasted OPEC for artificially inflating oil prices. As you know, OPEC, along with Russia, has achieved record compliance in draining the supply gut. Their goal essentially is to tighten supply in order to prop up prices because, you know, if you're OPEC, all you really have are oppressive regimes and lots of oil. So without this oil, life comes to a halt in a lot of these economies. So it is very driven by oil, and they're doing whatever they can to make sure that the price returns to at least a profitable level. Now, it is a bit of a conundrum for OPEC because the higher that oil rises, the more lucrative it becomes for the shale producers in the United States to enter the market. You got the guys in Cushing, you got the guys over across the United States that have a highly efficient oil production pipeline. Hell, they can hit profitability at $45 a barrel, some of these companies, right? So for a lot of these American companies, $45 a barrel, $50 a barrel is fine. They can make money that way. For a lot of these Middle Eastern producers, it gets a little bit tricky that way when 89% of your exports are based on oil. That stat was at one point true of Saudi Arabia. So Trump tweeted earlier in the day about that on Friday. As you know, OPEC's policy has worked and oil prices have hit more than 3-year highs. Just keep track of the weekly rig count data by Baker Hughes every Friday afternoon. Baker Hughes gives you the rig count data. It wouldn't surprise me at all to see U.S. shale producers or U.S. rigs in general continue to ramp up as oil stabilizes, you know, between $65 and $75 a barrel. Of course, we're also monitoring geopolitics. North Korea apparently is talking about easing off on its nuclear ambitions. It seems like the regime of Kim essentially says we're satisfied with the nuclear arsenal that we have. We don't want to give up what we have, but we don't necessarily seek to expand our arsenal. This is based on some of the updates I get from Wall Street Journal. The story has changed somewhat in terms of how willing the regime is to compromise its nuclear ambition, but it seems like there is some positive signs about negotiation with North Korea. It's funny how people criticize Trump for being, the warmonger. Trump is reaching out to North Korea, which is a huge step. A lot of people agreed with the Syria strike, although it seemed to have been contained. We saw about 105 missiles launched over Syria, not today, but last Friday. Hasn't really influenced the direction of the war. It doesn't seem like the U.S. is keen on, continuing those strikes. I believe the administration did remind everyone that the goal is to still get out of Syria. So there's hope for, hopefully we're moving in the right direction, and hope for peace in that country after 7 years of devastating war. So that always in the front line is the geopolitical picture. We're going to be monitoring that as we move forward. That covers it, everyone. Thank you for joining us. We really appreciate it. Visit hack.com for more resources, for trade recommendations, for daily analysis. We have great writers there, and a joint workplace. Thanks again. We'll catch you guys and girls next week. Take care.